how can we load the data from external stage into Snowflake? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see how to load the data from external stage into Snowflake, how to use the copy command in order to load the data into our Snowflake. Let me walk you over this one. In our previous videos, we have seen how to create an external stage using a create command. And we have also seen what are the different types of stages we have in Snowflake. What is the difference between those two stages? To repeat with you again, there are two types of stages. We have external stage and another one we have is internal stage. Now, let us not talk about internal stage because that is the one that we have it on a on-premises on local machine. But when I'm talking about the external stage, we can get it from our cloud providers, such as if we take about Microsoft Azure, we have Google Cloud Platform, we have AWS where we use S3 bucket, and for Microsoft Azure, we use Blob Storage, and in Google Cloud Platform that we have. So in my previous videos, I have shown you how to create this external stage using a create command. Now, is it enough that we have created an external stage? Is it not required in order to load the data from our external stage into Snowflake? That we are going to see it here. So in order to load the data, where should we load it? We need to have a table where we can load the data in it. So for this, I am creating a table with a table name public orders. The keywords in order to create a table that I am using is create or replace. So let me create a orders table first. In this table orders, I have my order ID column and the data type I have considered is varchar. Amount data type is integer. Profit column data type is integer. Quantity column data type is integer. Category column data type is varchar and the subcategory column with the data type varchar. So if we try to create this particular table, it is telling that database our first DB does not exist or not authorized. It means that we do not have this our first DB. So first we have to create that particular DB. So for this, what I am doing, I am creating a database, create or replace database, and the database name I am considering it as our first DB. So now let me create this and execute. Database our first DB is successfully created. If we carefully observe, the warehouse is not selected yet. We have to select our warehouse, then only we can execute something in this. So let me select this compute warehouse that we have created. Now when I'm trying to create this particular table, you can see that table orders is successfully created. If I refresh here, you can see that my our first DB is also there. And in the previous videos, we have created sample DB that is also available, where we have created our external stage there. And we have that AWS stage, right? So now we have created our database. We have created our orders table. So let us see whether our order tables is created or not. For that, I have the command select star. Star indicates everything from the particular table orders. And if we see here, where do we have this order table? Under our first DB database. Okay, so that I'm executing it here. As we can see, that order ID, amount, profit, quantity, category, subcategory, everything is there. But we have a table created, but there is no data in it. What is happening? We don't have any data in it, but we have our columns created in order table. Now we have to load the data in this particular order table. So from where we have to load it? Okay. So for this, we use a copy command. I am copying into. Where I'm copying? I'm copying into. Into where? Into my order table. Where is my order table? Under our first DB database. From where am I copying the information from my AWS stage, where at the rate you have to mention it for sure. And what is the file format that we have under our AWS stage? The file format, the type that we have is CSV file. If I show you the AWS stage, our first DB, okay, so it is from our sample DB external stage. Let me select this one and I'll execute it. We can see that under our AWS stage, there are three CSV files available: loan payments data, order details, and sample data, which are CSV file. Out of these three, we want order details, which we have created the order table now. Okay. So from this location AWS stage, I want to get this order details. All right. So for this, what I'm doing, I am copying it into my database in the table orders. From where? From my AWS stage. What is the file format? It is CSV file. And what is the delimiter? Delimiter is nothing but the columns which are separated, either with a comma, either with a space, either with a colon, either with a hyphen, or anything. So in my case, in this particular order details CSV file, my columns and informations are separated with the comma. That's why I'm considering it comma here. And what is this skip header equal to 1? What is the skip header? Most of the times what happens is that whenever we get the data, the column names, for example, if I show it to you here, we have order ID, amount, profit, quantity columns. If you see this, when we get a CSV file, all these column names, column headers will be inside the data. So in our CSV file, our column headers are inside the data. That's where I'm skipping the header and I'm assigning it as 1, where it's true. Now, there are two things. Earlier, when I tried to execute this list AWS stage, it told me that it does not exist in our first database. Where I went here and I have manually changed into my sample DB. Am I right? So now, if I execute this one also, it again, I have to come back to my our first DB database. Manually, I have to go and select it. If you want to get the fully qualified stage, then what you have to do, rather than directly mentioning AWS stage, you can mention @ symbol where you have this AWS stage. You have it in sample DB external stage. So there are two ways: either you select manually like this and you execute the whole thing so that the copy command will execute, where you have to just mention @AWS stage, or if you are in some other database, let us consider our first database. Now you are writing the fully qualified stage. It means that you are mentioning the database name and where you have this in external stage. And now if you execute it with this one, everything will be executed though you have in some other database. If you see here, it is telling that number of columns in file 2 does not match that of the corresponding table. So using file format option is on error. Okay, we have got some error. It is telling that number of columns is not matching with the table. Okay, if I list down my particular AWS stage, as I told that my Snowflake, when I'm executing it is getting confused because the type I have given CSV, that's fine. But in our AWS stage, we have loan payments data, that is also a CSV file. We have order details data, that is also CSV file. We have sample data, that is also CSV file. So which file you have to consider? So for that, what I'm trying to do, for the same copy command till here, I am just adding the option called files. And I'm telling that please choose order details CSV file. What I'm telling, please choose order details CSV file. So if I execute it, then we can see that the status is loaded. Either you can directly give this order details dot CSV by mentioning the files, okay, because we have three files, we have three data sets: loan payments data, we have sample data, and we have order details data. So where I have clearly mentioned that files, and what file you have to consider, order details CSV file, and you can see that the status is loaded. Okay, So if you want, you can even copy this one with the pattern. What is a pattern? So again, we are writing the same thing. We are copying into our first database. And from where are we getting this data? From our AWS stage, which is in sample database. Our file format is CSV. And the delimiter that I am segregating my each column information is with a comma. And I'm skipping the header if my header is inside my particular table. Now there is a pattern for my order that I have created, order table. So where you can see that I'm using a dot and the star symbol to it. So if I execute this one, you can see that copy executed with zero files proceeded. So now let me extract this information, select star from our orders. Then we can see that all the data that we have in order detailed particular CSV file, we have got it into our order table. This is how you have to copy the data from our external stage that we have created with the AWS stage into our Snowflake. So I did not manually enter all these data. We have some sample data in our AWS stage. Using the copy command, what I have done from my external stage where I have created AWS stage, from there I am getting the information into my Snowflake. So that's where I have created this copy command. I have created my table and we can see that it is clearly extracted with each and every column that we have created. All right. So this is how a copy commands works. And whenever you want to get the data or if you want to load the data from your external stage into Snowflake, this is the process that we have to follow. I hope this copy command will make best use of every viewer who are watching this video, where you can load the data and start working on Snowflake. In our next videos, we are going to see how we can transform this particular data that we have loaded. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.